Do you want to build quick mobile apps, but you just don't have coding knowledge? Well, Jotform has a new product for us. It's called Jotform APPS, and it's compatible with their other products, which is Jotform Forms and Jotform Tables. We can use those inside of Jotform APPS. Now, right now it's in beta stage, so I'm just waiting to see what's gonna come out next. Now, in this video, what I did is I built a restaurant app where people are going to scan the QR code, they're gonna have the app, and they're going to be able to make reservations via form. They're gonna view directions, promotions, and view other things inside of this app. So let me show you how I accomplished this and show you if Jotform APPS is the right product for you. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. Okay, this is my Jotform app that I've built. It's super easy to build, it's drag and drop. And before we get into the dashboard and how I actually built it, I want to show you how it's going to look on your mobile phone. So in this case, I am going to show you my mobile phone, and you can see I already have the app on my phone. Now, what it's going to do is that I am going to open up the camera. I'm going to scan the QR code or the link that's provided. It's going to open it up on my browser, and then I'm going to select add to my desktop. It's going to display a little prompt window where it tells me the instructions on how to do it. It's super simple. Basically, it's like three steps and you have the app icon on your phone. So let me go ahead and open it up right here on my phone. This is what I've built on Jotform APPS. And right now I have a welcome screen where I have my logo, header, I have a video that's going to be displayed, I have another logo, and I have a menu button that's gonna go to one of my pages here on my app. Other one is reservation that's gonna take me to another page, and I have some social media icons, and I decided to put a job application form on the bottom. So if I'm in the restaurant, I scan it and I'm looking for a job, well, I'll take advantage of it. It's just an idea. So if I click on one of my forms, I'll open it up and I'll click fill out form, and right inside of the app, I'm able to fill out the form right here for the job application. There we go, without having to go outside of the form. I can go into my other pages, which is menu, super popular on restaurant. If that's the app you want to build, I have the menu available right here. I can view promotions. So, hey, what's going on recently? Here's the promotions, and I have a slider where I'm going to view the promotions. In this case, I have the manual slider, but I can make this automatically switch around. Directions, if I want to view how to get there, well, I have a map there. I can also embed my Google Maps and view it there without the image. I can do like zoom. And I have a button that goes to Google Maps in case I want to find directions on how to get there. Okay, so back to the app. Again, the next page is reservations. So if I want to make a reservation for, I don't know, a party, just a table, and I can add those forms here if I want. If I click on it, I'll click fill form, and it's going to open it up. And I fill out the form and I'm making a reservation here on the app. Now it's pretty cool that we have this app. It might have a little few steps to add the icon to the desk screen of your mobile phone. But once you have it, it's pretty cool because people are gonna come back, they're gonna open the app. It's easy for them to find the menu, reservations, and you give them other things that you will use on your app that makes it interesting for them. So let me pause this for now and jump over to my desktop. Okay, so this is the desktop app, and right now I'm in preview mode. This is really helpful because I'm able to view how it's going to look on a mobile phone. There's phone, tablet, and desktop view for this. Let me turn the preview off, and this will open up the editor. Now, it's super easy, it's drag and drop, and what we're viewing right now, it's the main page, and then we see a new page here. This is my menu page. Every time that I create a page, it's gonna add it here on the footer. On the bottom right here, we see home, menu, promotions, directions. I'll double click on it and I'll change the name for it, and it's easy as easy as that. And I can add new pages here or just add another page by clicking here on add new page. Now all my pages are displayed right here and the elements are on the left. These are the elements that are available as of now. Remember, it's in beta mode and I am able to do all of that right now in beta. So like I mentioned before, I'm excited to see what's gonna come next once they're out of beta. So we can add forms, and these forms are tied to your Jotforms. So that means that if I add a form right here, I have my forms pop up and I've pre-built forms already. Now it's important that you build the form that you're going to use on the app. So it displays right here when you add it. The forms are also manageable in the design. In my video, well, on my demo app, the The form is actually white background, so I would put it as the same background as this one, so it flows with the same concept. But I'll select it here, I'll add form, and boom, it's added. I can add step forms also, so people know that they got to do two forms, or I can make them also, they got it required, that's also available here. So if I click on settings for this form, I have the options available. The form label, description, show form, element size, normal, large. I can shrink it if I want to take advantage of the size of the app and put two of them in the row, two elements, it could be different ones. I can mark as required and mark as completed also. And the style settings for this. Change the icon color, the button color, and all that good stuff. In this case, I'll delete it because, well, I'm not actually gonna use it here. All right, there we go, it's deleted. Other things that we have is heading. Well, basically it's just text as a header. Paragraph, link, document, if I want to add a PDF inside of here, the image you saw on my menu here. When I go to menu, these are images. We can add buttons. These buttons are pretty interesting. Let me go into this one. These buttons, if I go into options, I can do several things with them. Obviously, name the button. I can go to URL. I can send an email. I can make a call, navigate to a page. These pages are the pages that I've created on my app right here. So depending on the pages that you have down here, I select it and it's gonna jump to that page because that's what I'm going to do, navigate to a page. I can open a form also with the button. And if I'm gonna use a link like this case, well, it's gonna go there. In this case, I'm using shrink, so I have two in a row. Other elements that we have is featured widgets, image gallery, you saw my promotions page, the image slider, video, map, social follow, like the ones right here. Social follows have several social media accounts, all the main ones practically. If I type inside of Flickr, for example, anything, it's gonna pop up the Flickr icon and it's gonna display it now. If I don't have anything here displayed, it's not gonna load it. So if I don't have any Flickr social media accounts, oh, clicked away from it. All right, you just remove it and it's gonna remove the icons. So only the icons for the social media accounts you have are gonna pop up. We also have testimonial, which is really interesting for bringing giving fidelity for your clients to find out if other clients have felt good about your product or your service. Tables from Jotform tables, we can use those just as we would as forms. Reports, sent box, we have dividers and spacers to make our app look really nice. And on the right, we have our designer settings. So in this case, my app has a dark look on the background. I've selected the color scheme. There are several color schemes that you can test out. And if you don't like these, well, you can add your own colors here manually. And you can add a background image also. We have the app layouts. In this case, we're viewing the app layout default, but there's all strength. So if you don't want to do manually shrink each single one of those to take advantage of those two in a row, you can use all strength. You can use no icons, all strength, no icons. And there's several ones that obviously play around with them and you decide if that's what you're looking for. Next thing we have is the settings for this. Went to settings. By default, it's enabled. So once you create it, it's available, but we can disable it or disable on a date. So if you're using this app for something like, hey, you know what, a concert, and you're selling concert tickets on your app, obviously you can create a form where you can sell concert tickets and embed it here on the app. And you can disable it once the concert is over. Well, you set the date here. You can continue forms later if that's something you want, or they have to do it forcefully. Add to home screen model and progress bar, on or off. App name and icons, this is where we can edit them. For example, I called the restaurant, but you would call it what you call the app, okay? And the icon for it. The splash screen, how you want it to view, and the publish settings. So we can share this via link, they open it up. You can share the QR code by downloading it, or you can create your own if you like. And there's also the embed option for this form. So all those options are available right now. Now there's several reasons why you might want to create an app, like I mentioned before. In this case, you saw a demo for a restaurant, but what happens if you're a doctor? Well, it would be pretty cool when a patient arrives to the waiting room. Well, imagine having a QR code where the patient is gonna scan it, or you make them scan it because that's a process to jump to the next step, which is the doctor one-on-one. In that QR code, you can have an app that's built that opens a form that says, hey, you know what, all the information that you're going to need. A doctor is always going to ask you the first time, for example, your name, last name, your age, your height, your weight, previous illnesses that you might have, or why you're visiting them. So once they go to the doctor area, well, the doctor is going to open it up and it's going to view all the information and maybe just fill in some questions that you didn't fill out. So it saves them time and it looks professional. And you have that app ready where you have several things available inside of the app. Like I said, there's several things that you can create with Jotform apps. It's just going to depend on what you need it for. So like you saw there, it's drag and drop, no coding, super easy to build an app right away. Right now it's in beta, so let's see what they're going to come out with next. All right, I hope you liked this video. If you guys want to check out Jotform apps, that link will be in the description. I thank you all for watching and I'll see you on my next videos.